This will be a pretty exciting lecture because I'm going to talk about the basics of automating mainframes. Many people don't have any experience with what a mainframe looks like. So here I'll talk about the very basics to get you oriented. And then in the UiPath Level 2 course, I'll take it even deeper. So I've got UiPath open here, and I'm creating a new blank project. I'll call this mainframe-demo. Click on Create. The essence of doing mainframe automation depends on having the terminal activities installed. So if you haven't already installed the terminal activities, make sure you go into your activities panel, click on this button here to open up the activities management pane and install the terminal activities. Once you do so, you type in terminal here, and you can see that under app integration terminals, we've got a number of activities to choose from. Similar to automating Excel, where we had to use an Excel scope that we wrapped around all of our Excel activities, we pretty much do the same thing with terminal, because we'll use a terminal session to wrap around a bunch of these other terminal activities. Normally what I would do is put a sequence or a flowchart out here as the first activity, but to demo this, I can simply drag a terminal on here, and notice the first thing it does is asks me to configure the connection. There are several different types of terminal applications, and I can't teach all of them in this one basic lecture. But the one I'm going to deal with today is the Blue Zone terminal, which is produced by Rocket. So when I select that in the provider menu, it's asking me to specify an address or select a profile. I've got a profile saved, and this is something you'd have to talk to your IT team about, but I'll simply go into my C drive in a robotics directory that I created and double-click to select this profile that was saved by my IT team. So once that is selected, you click on OK. And that's going to pop up two different windows, a terminal wizard that you can use to help you record terminal activities, and also the terminal window itself. I'll talk more about these tools in my UiPath Level 2 course, but suffice it to say that interacting with a terminal window is easy enough if you understand the activities. You don't really even need to use this terminal wizard to get something done. So I'll close this up for now. And you can see that my terminal session is ready to use with a do sequence inside it. And this is where we would drop a bunch of our other terminal activities to do some work. Before we try to do anything, I'll just double click on the mainframe shortcut on my desktop here to open up a mainframe window. And I'm blurring some things out here because mainframes aren't easy to come by. You usually have to find them within a company you work at. And there are some things that I just can't show you in this mainframe window as a result. Ultimately, mainframes are pretty simple to interact with. What you're mostly going to be doing is typing text, using things like special keys, like the tab key or the F keys, like F1, F2, and F3, and then reading some information on the screen to ensure that the right thing happened. The nice thing about a terminal is that it's very low latency, meaning things happen instantly after you perform an action. Whereas with a web application, you often have to wait around for pages to refresh and things like that. So you can see that the cursor is waiting for me to type something up at the top left of the screen. What I'll do is type in a value there and hit return, and instantly I'm taken to another screen of the mainframe application. You can see down here at the bottom right of the window, this particular mainframe application tells me which row and column the cursor is currently sitting on. So you'll see it's currently row 17, column 20, and if I click right next to that, now it says row 17, column 21. And if I use my left arrow, I'm back to column 20. So again, I can simply type in a relevant value, and then I'll hit the tab key to move to the next field and type in a value for that. And as you can see down here at the bottom left, I could hit F3 to log off if I wanted to. So F keys will do different things on different screens. When I hit return, again, I'm taken to a new page. And again, near the bottom, there's a guide that shows me different kinds of keys that I can press to do different things. In this case, under the blurred rectangle, there's a menu of systems that I can choose to enter. And if I hit tab 1, 2, 3, 4 times, and then hit return, that's how I would enter this particular application to do some work. And again, mainframe automation is really pretty much that simple. You type text, you hit return, maybe you hit the tab key or F keys a few times, hit return again, and then maybe examine some text on the screen. That's pretty much it. And it is helpful to look at this column and row reference down at the bottom when you do need to read text in certain areas of the screen or put the cursor in a place where it's most relevant to type data. I think it said F3 to log off, so I'm going to try that. And notice that took me back to this main menu. So that's really it. Now let's see how we can do the same thing using UiPath. I'll close up this window, and we'll get started on our activities. It's important to know that when you use a terminal session like this, UiPath will open the terminal window, do whatever activities are in here, and then when it leaves this terminal session scope, it will actually close the terminal window automatically. Unless you uncheck this close connection box, and you have an opportunity to create a new variable here in the output connection field, and then later on in your process, you can essentially reattach to an open mainframe window using that output connection variable down here in the existing connection field. And all you need to do is keep unchecking close connection if you want to leave that terminal session open. So just remember that the output connection variable and existing connection variables are available to you. For now, I'm going to leave this close connection checked. And when I run UiPath, even though there's no activities in here, actually, let me drop a delay in there real quick. So I'll go into Library, Snippets, and just grab a 1 second delay, change that to 3 seconds, and hit run. So we'll notice that UiPath will open the terminal window, wait 3 seconds, and then close the terminal window again. So we didn't have to do anything, and UiPath is already doing some work with the terminal window. So you may recall that once the mainframe window opened, I typed a phrase on the landing page, and after that, I typed in my username and password. So let's demo that. I'll delete this delay, and I go back to activities. I've typed in terminal, and under the terminals node here, you can see we have several activities to choose from. Some of these do similar things, but just know that it's as simple as grabbing send keys and dropping it on there and typing in some kind of a string. After you type that text, you would want to use the send control key, and by default, this has transmit selected in the menu, and that's the same as a return key. If I click on that dropdown, you'll see that we have things like tab or any of these F1 or F2 keys, and off the screen here that you can't see, I've got home, delete, page up, page down, clear, and so on. So when I run the robot, it's going to open the terminal window, type in that phrase, hit the return key, and then we'll be on the next screen. So I'm going to drop that delay back in here so we can see it work. One thing I'll mention about these activities is that they all have a delay milliseconds and timeout milliseconds. Delay milliseconds is how long will UiPath wait before it does this? And each of these activities you'll see has that delay field on it. And they come with different defaults. Send keys, for instance, has a 300 millisecond delay, whereas send control key has 1,000 or 1 second. That kind of acts as a throttle for how quickly these activities will proceed. So you can play around with these and change them to longer or slower delays and see whether your automated process is reliable with short delays. I'm going to change this back to 3 seconds and run the robot. I'm recording on a smaller section of the screen, so you won't see the keys typed in, but rest assured when it does type in the phrase and hits return, you'll see the screen move to a new window. So I click on play. UiPath opens the terminal, types in the phrase, hits return, and now we're on that new screen. Waits 3 seconds and closes. So you can see by using send keys, send control key of transmit, we're already doing some work. Of course, to type in the username and password on that new screen, you would simply copy this and paste it here. And you would type in whatever that username is here. And then to get to the password field, you would again use send control key, but this time you would select tab and then either use send keys or send key secure, depending upon whether you have a plain text password or an encrypted password. So let's see if that works. I'll click on run. UiPath opens the mainframe, types in that first string, hits return, types in the username, tabs, and then closes. So one more thing you could do is you could use something like wait for text at position, wait for field text, or wait for screen text. Wait text at position and wait field text both require a little bit more thought and skill because you have to know what field you're looking for or use a particular row and column. Wait screen text allows you to simply type in any kind of text, and UiPath will look on the entire screen before it does something. So to demonstrate this, I'm going to drag this before I type in the username. And the text I'm going to wait for is username, because that's some text on the screen. So UiPath is not going to type username until it sees the word username on the screen. And to make this more clear, I'll just type in my username. So to demo this, I'm going to disable this transmit so that UiPath will type in this first string, and then I'll have to actually hit the return key myself, and it'll force UiPath to wait before it types in the username on that new screen. Oh, and actually I forgot that it's not username on the screen, it's user ID. So let me change this before we run it. So it'll wait for user ID before it types in my username. Let's run it. UiPath opens the mainframe and types in that initial string at the top left. Now it's waiting to see the word user ID on the screen before it types in the password. So I'll hit return now. And after I hit return, you can see that it immediately typed in the user ID and then tabbed to password. And now it's closing the window. So that's it. That's the fundamentals for interacting with the mainframe. Send keys, send control key of transmit or tab or any of these F keys, and then wait screen text. You can get a lot of stuff done using just those basic activities.